This is JP from Not the Lights Over Arkham. This time I will be testing out the Harvey Walters starter deck, and I will be playing the Waking Nightmare scenario from the Dream Eaters cycle. I didn't make any changes to Harvey's deck, so I won't be overviewing the deck that much. It is the out-of-the-box deck that comes with the starter pack. I also included the new basic weakness that comes in Harvey's deck, so no changes to that were made, and we are playing the Waking Nightmare. I was thinking which scenario would I want to play with Harvey, and I think Waking Nightmare offers a lot of challenge for Harvey. There are a lot of spider enemies in the later part of the scenario, so with Harvey's pre-built deck, that might be a difficult task for him to manage, but we'll see how that goes. So without further delay, let's get started. I have pre-shuffled the deck, so we can draw our opening hand. We get deduction, preposterous sketches, vault of knowledge, forbidden tome, and higher education. I think I will keep vault of knowledge and deduction and higher education, and I will mulligan those two. We get Celeano fragments and feed the mind. So I think that is a decent start for Harvey. Harvey's deck type is that he wants to draw a lot of cards, and while he's drawing cards, he gets to draw an extra card, and his deck also boosts his abilities and skills when he has a lot of cards in hand. Some cards add to the maximum hand size, like the Vault of Knowledge adds to the maximum hand size, and that is the way you get to draw most of your deck into your hand. One thing I forgot to mention, we start the game with Dr. Shivan Maheshwaran in play, and also I will be using these new curse tokens that I got for the Innsmouth Conspiracy campaign ahead of time, so I will be using those curse tokens as instead of the horror tokens to mark infested locations when we start drawing from the infestation pack, and I will be using this pack as an infestation pack. Okay, so I think we are ready to start, so let's see. So first action, I will play down the Vault of Knowledge. Just put it here. Second action, I think I'll just investigate here. So we are investigating 5 versus 3. It's an elder thing, and it's an axe. Axe is the number of infested locations. It is a 0 at the moment. So we succeed, we get this clue. Also, we trigger Vault of Knowledge, so we exhaust it. And we draw a card, and because after I draw a card in the investigation phase, I draw an extra card, so I get preposterous sketches, and also Occult Invocation, so we at least got one way to deal with enemies, and we got a bunch of cards. Last action, I'll just move to the records office. The records office is a tree shroud location with 2 clues per investigator. And triple action, you may do 4 basic investigation actions, but I think we'll just use deduction there next turn to get those clues. That is our turn. No enemies. We go to upkeep. We draw a card, and Harvey's ability doesn't trigger in the upkeep phase, so we can't draw an extra card. But still, now we, that we have the Vault of Knowledge in play, we are drawing a bunch of cards with Harvey. And we also gain one resource, and that is the first turn, so let's go to the next turn. We add a Doom to the agenda. The agenda Doom threshold is 2, so it will be a short one. The first encounter card is a locked door. Well, of course it is. So the records office is locked. So let's check. So we cannot investigate the location, but we can still discover clues. And we have the extensive research in hand. So we have 7 cards in hand. So this costs 5 because it is 1. It costs 6. If we play it, we still have 6 cards in hand. So I think first action I'll draw a card. I'll use the Vault of Knowledge to draw a card. And Harvey's ability to draw a card. So we have 10 cards in hand. We'll play the extensive research. So we have still 9 cards in hand. And it costs 3. And we discover 2 clues at our location. So we don't have to mind the locked door. So that was the second action. Last action, we'll just move back to the waiting room. And that is our turn. Let's see, we have 2 copies of Occult Invocation. And Arcane Enlightenment, Forbidden Tome, Preposterous Sketches, Feed the Mind, Celeano Fragments, and Higher Education and Deduction. So we have really... We have 9 cards in hand, so no enemies, we go to upkeep, we draw another card, we get another Higher Education, and we gain 1 resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add another Doom, so the agenda advances. So, unsettling developments. Shuffle the set aside spiders encounter set, and each set aside copy of Outbreak into the encounter deck, along with the encounter discard pile. And draw the set aside the Infestation Begins story card and resolve its text. So, we get this Infestation Begins, we shuffle these Outbreaks, and also the spiders counter set. Now the scenario begins to get difficult for Harvey, because now there are enemies in the deck, and Harvey is not that good at fighting, so we'll see how he can deal with all of the spiders. And now, because I so easily forget, I'll just move this infestation back here, so I better remember to do the infestation checks when we start doing them in at the end of the Mythos phase. So I think that's enough shuffling. Let's see. So we place 1 damage token to the location with the most clues. I'll just place it in the records office. And I'm not using the damages, as I said earlier. I'll use the curse tokens. For the remainder of the scenario, damage tokens or the curse tokens on location represent the spreading infestation. Each location with a damage or curse token on it, it is an infested location. We create a separate bag consisting of the following tokens: one skull, four tablet, and two cultist tokens. I have done that already. This is the infestation bag, and these are infestation tokens. They are not chaos tokens. Some abilities will instruct the player to make an infestation test. An infestation test may cause the infestation to spread to other locations or endanger investigators at infested locations. To resolve an infestation test, an investigator must reveal a random infestation token from the infestation bag and resolve the effects for that token and as indicated on the other side of this card. Flip this card over and place it next to the scenario reference card. So that is that, and now we have agenda 2A. So forced at the end of the mutos phase, make an infestation test. So now we continue with the mythos phase, so we draw an encounter card for this turn, and it's Rotting Remains. I won't draw from the investigation bag, but I'll just test with the 4 versus 3. Harvey has plenty of horror, or plenty of sanity, so we're not that worried about horror at this point. It's a cultist, and cultists reveal another token. If you fail and it is agenda 2 or 3, make an infestation test. So we just reveal another token. And it's an auto fail, so of course it is. I will take 3 horror, put 2 on Dr. Miles Braron and 1 on Harvey. We fail and we make an infestation test. Well, this isn't starting that well. And we get the tablet, and the tablet is set the token aside. That is the mythos phase ending, so we do the end of the mythos phase infestation test. And it's another tablet, so luckily nothing happens, but now there are more bad tokens than the tablets in the infestation bag. We restart our turn. First action, I will play down Celeano Fragments. So now, if we have 5 or more cards in hand, we get 1 plus 1 intellect, and 10 or more, we get plus 1 willpower, and 15 or more, we get plus 1 intellect again. And second action, we'll move to the experimental therapies ward. It's a 4 shroud location with 2 clues. And I will, for my last action, investigate here. I'll use deduction. So I'm investigating 7 versus 4. And it's a skull. It's a minus 1. Minus 3 instead if you are engaged with a staff enemy. Well, we are not, so we succeed. We get both of these clues. And we can use 4 clues to advance. So we put the set aside stairwell and basement door locations into play. Okay, let's do that. So stairwell, basement door locations. Let's shuffle these up. Okay. Then, if it's agenda 2 or 3, make an infestation test. So, we'll do that. And it's another tablet, so nothing happens. And that is our turn. No enemies. We go to upkeep. We get one card. And we gain one resource. So we got an encyclopedia. Now we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 cards in hand. So not enough to boost our willpower, but still. That is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom to the agenda. And encounter card is Glimpse of the Underworld. Put Glimpse of the Underworld in play in your threat area. Force when you would take damage and horror, take one additional damage or horror. Fast trigger ability. Discard Glimpse of the Underworld, take one damage and one horror. So I will, at the start of the investigation phase, just trigger this and get rid of it. Take one damage and one horror. Yeah, so the objective now is that if an investigator controls Randolph Carter, advance, and he is somewhere in these basement locations, so we will start moving into the basement. So we'll move to the stairwell. And it's a three-shot location with one clue. I think I'll just investigate here. And I won't commit anything to the tests. So I'm just investigating a 6 versus 3. It's a minus 1, so we succeed and we get this clue. And last action, we'll move into the first basement door location. And it's the morgue. It's a 5-shroud location with one clue. Test willpower 3. If you succeed, discover one clue at this location. If you fail, take one horror. Forced after the last remaining clue is discovered from morgue, make an infestation test. And no enemies, we go to upkeep, we draw a card, we get Witton Green, which is the new ally that comes in the Harvey Walters starter deck. We gain one resource. And that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add another doom. Encounter card for this turn is Swarm of Spiders. Swarming 2. X equals the number of swarm of spiders enemies at this location. So it's a one fight, one health, and X evade enemy. So we take two cards and attach them underneath this. I'll just put it over here because we're a bit tight on room on this side of the play area. And it's engaged with Walter, Harvey. Okay, I think we have to get rid of these spiders for our first action. I'll play Occult Invocation. We'll attack the spiders, and I think I will have to get rid of a couple of cards. So we are fighting with intellect instead of strength. You get plus one intellect and deal plus one damage for this attack for each card discarded as part of this card's cost. So I'll pay for two. I'll discard one higher education and a forbidden tome. So we are fighting 8 versus 1. And it's a plus 1, so these spiders are dead. Please go underneath my deck. Second action. I think I'll just investigate here. Actually, I think I'll draw a card. I'll trigger the Vault of Knowledge. I'll draw another card. And I'll draw another card with Harvey's own ability. So I have 10 cards in hand. I am investigating 6 versus 5. But I could do the willpower check, which is 5. I am at 5 willpower, so 5 versus 3. I think I'll just commit this to the test. So I'm just investigating, and I'm investigating 7 versus 5. And it's a plus 1. So we grab this clue. Last action, we'll move back to the stairwell. I think we forgot one infestation test somewhere there. Let's do that. So it's a skull. Skull is set this token aside, search the encounter deck and discover for a spider enemy and spawn it in the in at the infested location nearest to any investigator. So we'll just grab one of those swarming spiders. Yeah, this scenario is really fun, at least in my opinion, except that I always forget about the infestation test. It's just so in such a weird position in the mythospace steps, so that you just keep forgetting it. If it would be at the start of the turn, I think it would be easier to remember. So this is spawning 2, so we are. That's 2 cards underneath it. And I'll spawn it way over here. So we don't have to deal with it at the moment. Okay, so I think that is our turn. Enemies, no hunter enemies at least. So we go to upkeep. We draw a card. We get another encyclopedia and we gain one resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add another doom. We are at 3 of 6 doom. Encounter card for this turn is Outbreak. We perform an infestation check. There are only 3 tokens in the bag. And now the tablets count as skulls. And we get a cultist. So set the token aside, choose a location connected to an infected location. And we infect that location also. And if we had 2 cultist tokens, we would put all of the infestation tokens into the infestation pack. That was the mythos phase, but at the end we do the regular infestation test. And we get the cultist, so again, we'll just put it here. And now we put all of this back into the bag. Okay, and now we can start the investigation phase. First action, let's count our cards. We have 10 cards in hand. First action, I'll move to the next basement door location. Go here. Okay, so we found the private room. It's a 4 shroud location. Action parlay test, willpower 2. If you succeed, test intellect 2. If you succeed, investigators at this location may spend 1 clues per investigator as group to give the control of the set aside Randolph Carter asset to an investigator at this location. Okay, I think we have to try and get Randolph Carter right away. So I will do the parlay action here. So I have 10 cards in hand. So I have willpower 5 and intellect of 6. So we test willpower 5 against 2 first. It's a minus 2. And next we test intellect 6 versus 2. It's a minus 3, so we succeed. So we get control of Randolph Carter. So now we have a plus 1 will and plus 1 intellect from Randolph Carter. Then we advance. So Carter's statement basically tells us that we need to stop the infestation. We shuffle the encounter discard pile into the encounter deck. Then we have one action remaining. Let's check our new objective. So each infected location gains action test willpower X to attempt to seal the rift. X is the location shroud. Is this location shroud? Investigators at this location may spend one clue per investigator as a group to automatically succeed. If you succeed, replace the damage token on this location with the horror token. For the remainder of the game, this location cannot be tested. And I will be using these blessed tokens as the horror tokens for the sealed rifts instead of horror. Just think they are visually more pleasing to look at than the horror and damage tokens. Last action, we'll just move to the stairwell. And that is our turn. Enemies, nothing happens, upkeep. We draw a card, we get an extra with and green. Now we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 cards. We have one too many, so we have to discard something. I'll just discard with and green. So we have 10 cards in hand, we gain one resource. And that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add another Doom to the agenda. We are at 4 of 6. Encounter card for this turn is Rotten Remains. I am at willpower 6, so I'll just test it. So 6 versus 3. 6 versus 3. I have 10 cards in hand and Randolph, so I have willpower 6. So another autofail. I just don't understand. Every time I test for Rotting Remains, I keep on failing that test. So I'll take 2 on Randolph and 1 on myself. Then we'll do the infestation test. I think I will be using the doctor if we get a bad one this turn. So, infestation test is, it's a tablet, so nothing happens, that is good news. We go to the investigation phase. First action, we'll move to the experimental therapies ward. Second action, we'll move to the emergency room. Emergency room is a two-shroud location with one clue. And last action, we'll do the willpower test. I'll spend one clue here, so we automatically succeed. So we change this to this, and that is that. So enemy phase, nothing happens. Upkeep, we draw a card, and we discard a card, and we get the source. And that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We are at 5 Doom of 6. Encounter card for this turn is... oh my god. Rotting Remains. Cue the autofail. I'm just testing it 6 versus 3. Hopefully this time we won't hit the old spell. Be so stupid. Well, it's an elder sign, so let's see what Harvey does with the elder sign. So it's +1, draw a card. So we draw a card, we get the cryptic writings. After you draw cryptic writings during your turn, play it. Well, it wasn't our turn because we drew it in the middle space. How unlucky is that? Well, whatever. We'll just try to... I think I'll do the... I'll try to get some victory points at least from this location. So, first action, I will investigate here. I just no point in committing anything. I'm investigating 7 versus 2. It's a -4, so we get this clue. Second action, we'll move to the we forgot to do the infestation test again. It's a skull. We would spawn an enemy. I'll use the fast triggered ability on Dr. Maheshwaran. When an investigator reveals a skull or a cultist symbol on an infestation token, remove Dr. Shivani Maheshwaran from the game, cancel the token and return the token into the bag. So I'll cancel that and put the skull back into the bag. I think I did, yeah. So we don't get the enemy. And now I will spend the clue. And I will automatically succeed in this for my last action. And that is my turn. So enemy pays, nothing happens. Upkeep, we draw a card. And we have to discard 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 cards in hand, so I'll discard 2, so that goes, and I think one of the encyclopedias go. Well, it's a... We really don't need the book icons, so let's see. Cryptic writings. Okay, so that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We are at 6 doom of 6, so the agenda advances. Hell breaks loose. Search the encounter. Find each suspicious orderly enemy in play and replace it with the set aside corrupted orderly enemy. Search the encounter deck and discard pile for each copy of suspicious orderly and remove them from the game. Shuffle the set aside agents of Atlak Natcha encounter set. Each remaining set aside corrupted orderly enemy and the encounter discard pile into the encounter deck. And one skull and one cultist token into the station bag, so I'll do that. Then we add these and we add these and discard pile. So let's search for the suspicious orderlies. Remove them. Add these and the agents of Atlak Natcha and shuffle the encounter deck. Okay, encounter card is, well, it's a locked door. Let's just put it way over here. Okay, so now we just need to get that last infestation token removed. So let's do the infestation test first. It's a cultist, but the infestation cannot spread anymore because we blocked the only path for it to spread. That's good news. First action, we'll move into the records office. these spiders engage us. Second action, I'll just occult invocation them, and I'll discard two cards from hand. So I'm five, six, seven, eight, nine versus one, and deal three damage. Of course, it's the auto fail. Of course, it is. So yeah, last action, we'll just take the attack of opportunity and spend one clue to change this into a sealed token, and we take three damage from the spiders. I'll take it all, Harvey, and then we get to advance the act. So the next step, check Campbell. If Dr. Mahesh Varan joined the investigation, she was in play when the scenario ended. Resolution 1. If Dr. Mahesh Varan joined the investigation and she was not in play when the scenario ended. Resolution 2. So we get to resolution 2. We record in our Campbell log that Dr. Mahesh Varan is missing. Perhaps you could have saved her. The lead investigator suffered one mental trauma. Your companion's condition was worsened. If you are playing the Web of Dreams and the Dream Quest as an interconnected 8-part campaign, record in campaign A campaign log that dreamers grow weaker. If you in your campaign log record Randolph escaped hospital with the investigators, any one investigator may choose to add Randolph Carter chain to the waking world to their deck. This card does not count towards the investigator's deck size. Also, skip to resolution 5. Each investigator earns experience equal to the victory X value of each card in the victory display. So we got 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 experience. Well, that's okay. And then we remove the infestation back. We do the interlude if we were playing a campaign. And that is it. So, yeah. I think with some tweaking, Harvey could have some more ways to deal with enemies. Now there are basically the occult invocations and the disc of is Itzamna in the deck to deal with enemies, and that is it. Okay, no other way to deal with enemies in the starter deck, so adding some... I've got a plan, and maybe, well, some other cards that can deal damage would help a lot. But overall, because Harvey is such a good investigator, playing him through solo is much easier than some of the other starter deck investigators. So I'm not that big of a fan of Harvey Walters as an investigator and an archetype. It's just a bit boring to hold like 10 cards in your hand and just be good at everything except for fighting maybe, but still. Yeah, but still we managed to beat the scenario, so hope you guys enjoyed this playthrough with the Harvey Walters starter deck. Thanks for watching, and until next time.